Welcome to Whiteboard Programming, where we simplify programming with easy to understand whiteboard videos. And today I'll be sharing with you what is a decentralized exchange, how it works, DEX types, and what advantages do they offer. So without any delay, let's get started. To state its definition, a decentralized exchange or a DEX is a place where people can go to trade cryptocurrencies without any intermediary. Seems simple, right? Let's dive deeper. But first, to better understand what a decentralized exchange is, it's important to understand how centralized exchanges work. So let's look into them first. Well, a centralized exchange such as Binance or Coinbase is a place where people can buy, sell or trade cryptocurrencies and tokens listed on that exchange. Now, let's say you want to buy some Bitcoin. Then you need to go to exchange, sign up by providing some banking details and identifying information, and deposit some cash. And sometimes this process takes days, which accounts as one of the major drawbacks of centralized exchanges versus decentralized exchanges. Now, such exchange will tell you the price based on an order book of people buying and selling at different amounts. And you can make the transaction as per your convenience too. We'll discuss about this later in this video, so let's move on. Now, returning to the steps, you need to think, hey, what happens next? Well, once you make a purchase, the exchange will show those Bitcoins in your account, and you can trade for other tokens on the exchange. Are you feeling amazing that you've earned your Bitcoins? Well, actually, you don't really hold them, because you're entrusting the exchange to act as a custodian on your behalf. And any trading you do, like swapping Bitcoins for Ethereum, aren't occurring on a blockchain, but within the exchange's database. Further, these exchanges pool users' cryptocurrency into wallets, which are often claimed as hot wallets connected to the internet and are fully controlled by the exchange. And the exchange even controls your private keys in this process. But there are also ways around this, as exchanges allow you to transfer your tokens to a private wallet. But this adds an extra step later on if you wish to trade that crypto. Now, the appeal of decentralized exchanges or DEX is the security they provide, as a centralized exchange can limit your access to your crypto, restrict or halt your ability to trade it, or even fall vulnerable to hackers. On the other hand, centralized exchanges are generally far easier to use for newcomers, and they can often offer fast trading because they're not beholden to respective blockchain infrastructure. Now, as naive as it may sound, this has been Coinbase's biggest achievement and has helped them become a household name for crypto curious folks around the globe who are looking to dip a toe into buying crypto but are intimidated by the process. The majority of these people let Coinbase or any other centralized exchange act as a custodian for their funds and are just fine with it. So, as now you've got the fundamental understanding on centralized exchanges, let's understand how do decentralized exchanges work. Now, as decentralized exchanges use smart contracts and users get to keep the custody of their funds, here every trade incurs a transaction fee, along with the trading fee, and in the same essence, traders interact with smart contracts on the blockchain to use DEXs. And a DEX or a decentralized exchange works to handle this in one of three ways. Number one, order book DEXs. These type of decentralized exchange compile records of all open orders to buy and sell assets for specific asset pairs. Here, buy order signifies that a trader is willing to buy or bid for an asset at a specific price, while a sell order indicates that a trader is ready to sell or ask for a particular price for the assets under consideration. The spread between these two prices determines the depth of the order book and the market price on the exchange. In their initial days, the order book decentralized exchanges were typically slow, offered limited liquidity, and typically required traders to deposit their tokens to a smart contract controlled address to ensure orders could be automatically executed, which many would argue made them partially centralized. However, things have come along in leaps and bounds since then, and there are now a wide variety of decentralized order book based exchanges in operation, as well as potentially dozens more in development. Many of these are now able to settle trades in a non-custodial and trustless manner. Some of the most popular order book based DEXs for popular platforms include the following. Lastly, order book DEXs have two types, on-chain order books and off-chain order books, which I'll explain in the future uploads. So be sure to hit that subscribe button to be notified. Number 2. Automated Market Maker or AMM. Today, the vast majority of popular DEXs fall into the category of Automated Market Maker or AMM. With AMMs, assets are priced using a simple mathematical formula and are organized into liquidity pools, which are rebalanced when users add or extract liquidity from one side of the pool by trading. Further, do note that AMMs do not have an order book and generally don't support more complex order types like limit, take profit, and stop loss orders. But they do generally allow users to contribute their assets to the liquidity pool and earn a share of fees generated by trades that source liquidity from these pools. Some of the popular examples of AMM protocol-driven DEXs are Uniswap, Balancer, and Curve. Also, here the exchanges are often ranked according to the amount of funds that are locked in their smart contracts, called as Total Value Locked or TVL, as the AMM model has a downside when there is not enough liquidity in the pool. This is what we call as slippage problem, and it occurs when a lack of liquidity on the platform results in buyer paying above the market price on their order. Further, investors are also exposed to problems like impermanent loss, and I've explained this in detail in this video. Link for the same is given in the description, so feel free to check it out. Next, number 3, DEX aggregators. Now, these use several protocols and mechanisms to solve the problem associated with the liquidity of the network. Essentially, these platforms aggregate liquidity from several different DEXs to minimize slippage on large orders, optimize swap fees and token prices, and also offer traders the best price possible in the shortest possible time. Further, just so you know, protecting users from the pricing effect and decreasing the likelihood of failed transactions are two other significant goals of DEX aggregators. And also, some DEX aggregators use liquidity from centralized platform to provide users with a better experience, and all this happens while remaining non-custodial by leveraging specific integrations with specific centralized exchanges. By now, I believe you've got a fair idea about what are decentralized exchanges and how they generally function. Next, let's look into the advantages of using a DEX. Number 1. Anonymity. As when users exchange one cryptocurrency for another, their anonymity is preserved on DEXs. Number 2. Token availability. Centralized exchanges have to individually vet tokens and ensure they comply with local regulations before listing them. Decentralized exchanges can include any token minted on the blockchain they are built upon, meaning that new projects will likely list on these exchanges before being available on the centralized counterparts. Number 3. Reduced counterparty risk. Counterparty risk happens when the other party involved in a transaction does not fulfill their part of the deal and defaults on its contractual obligations. Because decentralized exchanges operate without any intermediaries and are based on smart contracts, this risk is eliminated. Number 4. Reduced security risk. Experienced cryptocurrency users who custody their funds are at a reduced risk of being hacked using DEXs, as these exchanges do not control their funds. Instead, traders guard their funds and only interact with the exchange as and when they wish to do so. And if the platform gets hacked, only liquidity providers face the risk, not the traders themselves. Further, despite the discussed advantages, there are various drawbacks or disadvantages of using a decentralized exchange, which include number 1, smart contract vulnerabilities. We have seen in the past how vulnerability has cost millions to platforms in crypto world. DEXs are no exception. Though there are security audits done in a decentralized exchange, auditors may even be unable to foresee potential new exploits that can cost liquidity providers their tokens. Number 2. Demand of technical knowledge. Now, DEXs are accessible using cryptocurrency wallets that can interact with smart contracts, and not only do users have to know how to use these wallets, they also have to understand security-related concepts associated with keeping their funds secure. That's why, without the fundamental technical knowledge, users can commit various errors which may lead to a loss of their valuable funds. withdrawing coins to wrong network, overpaying transaction fees, and losing out on impermanent loss are just a few examples of what could go wrong. Number 3. No customer service. We all can realize that centralized exchanges work much like the way banks do. They have customers whom they mostly want to keep happy and provide dedicated service in doing so. But in a truly decentralized exchange, there is no such actor on the other end. The developers who created the protocol don't have the same relationship with the users the way a centralized exchange like Coinbase does. You only have a DEX community you can turn up to in case you face any difficulties, and I would like to bring it to your notice that you are responsible for your own money while dealing with a decentralized exchange. Number 4. Unvetted token listings. So anyone can list a new token on a decentralized exchange and provide liquidity by pairing it with other coins. This can leave investors vulnerable to scams such as rug pulls that make them believe that they are buying a different token. Scary, right? Now, to solve this, some decentralized exchanges ask users to verify the smart contract of the tokens they are looking to buy. And while this solution works for an experienced user, it circles back to specific technical problem for others. Lastly, I'd like to say that decentralized exchanges keep evolving and try to embrace blockchain's ethos of trustlessness and privacy. And while some people find it reassuring from a security perspective that their token remain in their possession until they trade them, some find it troublesome as the level of responsibility is intimidating and the risks are concerning. With that, I hope this video was helpful and served value. If you love my content, feel free to smash that like button, and if you haven't already subscribed to my channel, please do, as it keeps me motivated and helps me create more content like this for you.